Hello everybody, my name is Stef van Dongen, I'm 34 years old, and the last 10 years I've been working on what I call the co-creation economy. And I did it on my own way because I don't have a large corporation behind me, I'm just a small entrepreneur from Rotterdam, the Netherlands, and I don't have money to pay expensive advisors, but I'm part of a network of thousands of professionals, things that they could not do if they were alone. And we share a passion, and that is that we believe in an economy of the crowd. We believe in an economy that creates value for a planet and all people that live on that planet. And that's why we devote our talents and our time to start up new businesses that address the major social and environmental issues in this world. So the next 9 minutes, I will talk about my story. I grew up in a little village in Rotterdam, or in the Netherlands. And I'm from a family of entrepreneurs. I got entrepreneurship for breakfast, for lunch, and for dinner. So that's why I think I had my first company when I was 17 years old, and I studied business. I did my business administration. To be honest, I was sincerely convinced that I would be a millionaire before my 30th birthday. But then a mountain changed my life. This mountain is called Mount Merapi. It's an active volcano in Indonesia. And together with my best friend, I climbed this mountain when I was 19 years old. We went up with a group of German seismologists that were going up to measure the activity of the volcano. And I love to be in nature, especially climbing volcanoes. It's a beautiful experience. You do it at night, you see the lava coming out of the slopes. Every stone you touch, it's warm. You smell the sulfur. And you will be rewarded with a beautiful sunrise when you're on top of the mountain. That morning, we were enjoying the sunrise. At 8 o'clock, the mountain woke up and started shaking. So me and my friend, we saw shit. Let's go down. The German seismologists, they were like really excited. They said, yes, this is our chance to measure the activity, the volcano. But I've never ran down a mountain that fast in my life. 2 hours after we reached the valley, this happened. The Germans still on top. So, as a 19-year-old guy, my world was turned upside down, you know? And I started to ask myself questions like, who am I? What's my talent? What gives me energy? What do I have to bring to this world? And it was in that moment that I decided to start listening to my inner self and to start making decisions based on that feeling. And it was in that moment that I decided that everything I would do next would be should be meaningful. So that's why I started Enview. Enview is an organization that develops sustainable social innovations and brings them to the market. We set up companies, we call them WOW projects. And a WOW project that should be groundbreaking in its industry, it should be scalable, there should be a business case, but first of all, it should give you the WOW feeling in your stomach. It's shit, this is going to change, it will change the world. And the thing I like about Enview is that we do it with 8,000 passionate professionals that share their time, their expertise, their networks, and their creativity to do amazing things. And everybody does it in its own way, in its own time, and at its own pace. So the first company that we started is called the Sustainable Dance Club. It's a company that started with the idea that can we make a night out dancing better for the environment than staying at home? You know, I love dancing, so with my friends we started working on this idea. And we did it. Like, we now have a company that facilitates dance clubs and festivals around the world to become more sustainable. And one of the features of this club that we offer is the dance floor that generates energy.
Every time we take a step, we leave energy behind. What if we could capture this energy as a clean source of electricity? Dutch architects Dol are developing the technology to capture the energy of dancers like these, then using it to power the club's music and lights. Certain materials produce electricity when squeezed. This is known as the piezo effect. So a dance floor can become one big generator, turning every movement into new power.
Oh, that happens. Thank you. In order to make this happen, like 200 crazy girls and guys are working together. Lexi designing the first prototypes of the floor, or making actually the first pilots that we are now delivering, offering to dance clubs. We have many people around the world that are sending us environmental impact studies of the clubs in their neighborhood. We had dance club owners that were developing with us the business model that was attracting for them, but also for us. So why did they do it? Because they liked it, because they could have free tickets to good clubs, because they wanted to personally develop themselves, or students that would earn school credits. So amazing things can happen when you push the button that is called passion, I think. And for the next, I would like to give you another example. 4 years ago was the first time I went to India. And if you go out of the airport in India, the first thing you see is this. It's an autorickshaw. It's a three-wheeler. There are millions of autorickshaws driving around in Asia. But I also saw it like they pollute like crazy. But when I was in India, I used those vehicles a lot. And I start talking with them, the drivers behind it. They start sharing stories, amazing stories. But also, we discovered that they live at the bottom of the economic pyramid, earning $3 or $4 a day, facing all kinds of social problems, like prostitution or abuse. Banks that don't want to offer them bank accounts. Well, what do you do if you don't have a bank account? Think of it. So at the end of this trip, we decided to co-create, together with the drivers, a solution to increase their quality of life and to reduce the ecological footprint. We set the ambition. We want to have 1 million clean autorickshaws and happy autorickshaw drivers and their families. So we did. Together with like the drivers, some 200 students, young professionals and students from the Netherlands and in India, we started developing a company called Three Wheels United. Students have been working on the affordable technology for the tuk-tuks, business professional designing the social business case, senior executive were coaching the people in the project and opening up their networks, and were like overviewing the quality of the whole project. So last month, we introduced the company to the market. We have a partnership with one of the biggest banks of India to provide the drivers with bank accounts, with life insurance, with health insurance, with fair loans. We're also working on a model to let the community co-own part of our company. So another example of how we collaborate. We run our organization on ideas how the co-creation economy should look like. So we often work in situations that are very uncertain, they're very complex, and the data is very unreliable. Like many of the drivers, they don't even have an identity papers. So we have to discover our road. We test our assumptions on the road, and we often make the decisions based on our gut feeling. We run a company based on a non-loss model. So we're not in there for the maximum return. We make decisions, investment decisions, based on the maximum impact that we can create. For me, those are very important principles of the co-creation economy. An economy where people are engaged because they're challenged, and people take responsibility to co-create a new economic system. And actually, we are in the middle of a system change. We need new models for production, we need new models for education, for distribution, and we need to ensure that all those new models are a huge economic opportunity in itself. So I'm convinced that a new generation of pioneers is the driver behind this new economy. Young entrepreneurs that are full of passion, full of creativity, that have the energy and the drive to mobilize their own networks, like you saw yesterday, many examples of them. Young people understand the concept of co-creation, of sharing. We understand that it's in our own interest to do that. It's in our DNA. We grew up with social media like Facebook and Twitter and YouTube. Those platforms exist because we share. So that's, we should take the lead in this change. But we cannot do it alone, because we need to connect our wild hairs to the wild and gray hairs, to the wise and gray hairs. We should benefit from the wisdom of the generations, the wise men and women that already did it. We should not make the same mistakes, and we should learn from them. And we should do it together. That way, I think only we can lift our society to the next level. So, Brazil, we need like a new economic system that facilitates massive collaboration, that facilitates like new models. We need it now. I think it's possible. So let your heart speak and do it. Thank you.